spider. It's the size of a Honda.
A Honda.
What
is that supposed to mean?
Well, exactly what I said. It's the size of a Honda.
You mean like the car?
Yeah.
Well, why didn't you just say it was the size of a car?
Well, because it's specifically the size of a Honda.
Okay, the size of a car, the size of a Honda. What's the difference?
What do you want me to say? It's specifically the size of a Honda. Go and see for yourself.
All right, jeez. You're going to get so worked up about it.
Yeah.
That's incredible.
I know, right?
That spider is specifically the size of a Honda.
Well, not for long. We're going to blast the crap out of it.
Unless you've got bullets, because I'm out.
Wait, you're out?
Yeah, I ran out after the snakes.
Well, crap, I'm out too.
Well, crap, what are we going to do?
Well, I suppose we could go back through that door. Snakes?
No. Worse. A title sequence.
The Secretary General of the UN was reached for comment, but said, quote, "Why are you asking me this? It's a comedy skit in a high school video production." After much deliberation, the House of Representatives struck down a measure to regulate hip space bears. The House cited gaps in the law that will both extend it to include hipster space bears and allow psychedelic space bears to fall through the... Got that out. All right, stop that. The Department of Defense announced today that it will be taking measures to stop terrorists from indoctrinating our children with ungodly anti-capitalist dogma. When asked if the DOD meant communists, the representative of the DOD said, quote, "Do you like terror, you stinking hippie?" In Tribeca today, a very large... Hey, I see you doing that! Cut that out! You keep the camera on me! On me! In Tribeca today, a very large rabbit stopped several lanes of traffic on the I-95. The rabbit was not reported of being of freakish proportion, but... Hey! Stop it with the jump cuts! I will not have it! I am the star of the show! I'm the bleeping star! Me! The rabbit was not being reported of being of freakish proportion, but it was large enough that several people stopped to Instagram it. And now, the kindergarten sketch. Oh, wait!
I just want to work
here.
Okay.
Dude. What are we gonna do with this?
Just toss it.
Yeah.
We put it
in. No. I wanna put one of the tables next to the... You're gonna send me the branch here.
Oh, okay.
So, where do I put this?
On the ground. Wait a second. We're not ready yet. So...
Yeah.
I don't know what you're doing. Like... Go.
Go to the next sketch. Hello? Yes. She's dead.
What?
Yes, Mary?
John, who's dead?
What?
Who's dead?
Oh, you are, Mary.
But John, I'm not dead.
Yes, you are. The truth will begin to sink in shortly. Hello? No. Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes. No. Now, did you not hear what I just said? Okay, she's dead.
John, I'm not dead!
You did not hear anything. Dead people do not talk, silly.
Why did you keep saying I'm dead, John. I'm not dead.
Dead people do not talk, Mary. There's a philosophy that you should begin to adopt now, okay?
John, if I was dead, I would be in a casket or an urn or something.
Mary, dead people talking takes away valuable oxygen from the living, including me, okay? Okay? And how do you think that makes me feel?
I bet it makes you feel like rubbish.
It does. You're right, it does.
Well, then you can feel how I feel about now.
Mary! Hello. Hi there. No. No. Did you not hear what I have been saying for the past 2 phone calls? She is dead, okay? Oh, you thought you heard something. Okay. Well, I have the solution. Hear that, my pal? Hear that, buddy? She's dead.
Peace at last.
John? You missed?
Oh, did I, Mary? Did I now?
Yes. You kind of did.
And they were never seen again. Wow. Children, what story does this remind you of? Remember the story I told you all last week after you stupidly spilled glitter on the rug? Who did I say was gonna come and do very bad things to you all if you didn't shape up? Don't you remember?
Ted Bundy.
Ted Bundy, very, very good. All right, now in more literary terms, what is this story an allegory for? Oh Christ, you don't know what an allegory is. Well, this story is really an allegory for the Christmas night, the year that Daddy had left, and Mama's got you locked in the closet while she turns tricks for 5 hours, and you starve because there's nothing to eat except a pack of ramen noodles, and the microwave is broken, so you have to learn how to work Daddy's little propane tank, and you only eat your noodles al dente, and then you find a way to stuff it all inside you because bulimia is the next best thing to starvation. Johnny, pass me my drink. Oh, excuse me, children. Oh, acetone rich. Anyway, all right, now everyone take out your copies of Eat, Pray, Love so we can rip out all the pages and realize that none of us will ever be in Italy enjoying endless amounts of gelato and cappuccino and eating any pasta dish we want to before we head off to the East because we realize that life is nothing more than this classroom.
Oh. Miss Arch, I don't know what you're saying.
Were you born mentally handicapped, little Annabelle?
Yes.
Didn't your mother always tell you to come to class prepared? You see, Annabelle, school is like one great big wrestling match where there are winners and losers. And this pipeline creates a world of prisoners or bankers or those in the sad mediocre middle who think it'll be a great idea to pursue an education degree for 4 years. You figure, oh, I can mold the youth, and oh, summer's off, and 48 Klonopin prescriptions later you realize your life is stuck in some stupid classroom teaching you little twits. Little Annabelle, your daddy's stocks may be high, but you'll never inherit any of his wealth because losers like you need to file for government assistance before tax season is over. What?
I have to use the body.
There is never any time to piss unless it's damaged to kidney, because at that point you have no control.
The number to write and complain is 636 North South 4th Street, under the stairs by the maintenance shaft. If you see the pigeon man, do not make direct eye contact, just walk away. That number again is...
Nautical coordinates 345 mark 626. If you see land or hope for rescue, you've gone too far. Again, the number to call and complain is...
Mm.
Some things in life are bad. They can really make you mad. Other things just make you swear and curse. When you're chewing on life's gristle, don't grumble, give a whistle. And this'll help things turn out for the best. And always look on the bright side of life. Always look on the light side of life. If life seems jolly rotten, there's something you've forgotten, and that's to laugh and smile and dance and sing. When you're feeling in the dumps, don't be silly chumps. Just purse your lips and whistle, that's the thing.